Welcome to a Fallout 76 episode. Well, the PTS just opened, and I'm about to show you some of the weapons and armor you can get from the Steel Dawn questline. So, fair warning, this contains non-story spoilers. Now, when I first came into the PTS today, all of us found ourselves wearing this very cool cave diver outfit, and we all spawned in at Fort Atlas, the old Atlas Observatory. And all of these items were already in our inventory to try out. So let's have a look at the Brotherhood Recon armor set first of all. Now my PTS pre-made character is at level 52, but all of this armor is at level 40, so I'm pretty sure we can expect to see all of these armor pieces, obviously not the helmet, at level 50. I think the damage resistant numbers are pretty good, and I really love the look. And there again is that cave diving suit. It is basically a hazmat suit. And here's a closer look at the armor, and I think the one thing I like about it is the kind of homage to a samurai warrior outfit. I love the flared bottom of the chest piece, and I think they did a really, really nice job on this combat armor, or recon armor as they're calling it. Also, there is a communist commander hat and communist commander outfit. There's a quick, I'm trying to get a bit more even lighting in here. It's night outside, so I had to kind of scoot inside this overseer's office here to give you guys some nice lighting. So there's a look at the communist hat. Communist commander hat. There we go. And the outfit. Just checking for any stats and things. Okay, on to the next one. There's also a jaguar pattern pantsuit. Long sleeve, long pants, one cuff rolled up, and looks like the pant cuffs are rolled up. Here's a closer look at the stats. Also a swamp camo hazmat suit. Looks pretty much like the Emmett Mountain hazmat suit or the prototype hazmat suit. A really nice paint job on that. Another closer look. Same thing, about 1,000 radiation resistance. A tulip sky blue pantsuit. Please remember, this is the PTS, so the colors might be a little off either in this room or in the PTS. And I think you can see more of the sort of sky blue color here. And what we've all been waiting for, the weapons. This is a Crusader pistol. This is at level 30. You have a damage of 28, and it's a 10 millimeter. The range is pretty good. No, it's just a default pistol, the Crusader pistol. The Hellstorm missile launcher. Trust me, I'm going to let these all loose in the room in a minute or so. Brotherhood of Steel symbol on the side of the Hellstorm missile launcher. Level 50, damage of 401. Mind over matter. This is a Ghoul Slayer's plasma pistol. With plus 50 damage resistance while aiming, so you've got a damage of 29 and energy damage of 29. The Oathbreaker. This is a 40% more power attack. It is an anti-armor. I think this is similar to the Warglaive. Oh, it's a plasma. Oh, this is a plasma blade. The Oathbreaker. I like this. Okay, we have a plasma cutter. Damage 46, energy damage 68, standard blade. Hopefully that means mods. That's one of mine. The Fact Finder. This is a 44 pistol with damage of 105 with the bull barrel. This is a two-shot explosive with 25% less VATS action point cost. That's a nice little pistol. I think it's one of the better pistols we've seen. Most people don't use the 44s. I use 10 millimeters, but that's nice. Okay, what else we got? The Farmhand. This is a Ghoul Slayer Swing Speed Super Sledge with damage of 149. So those are all the weapons that they gave us in our pre-made character pack. I haven't started any of the quests. So let's go back up to the Crusader pistol, and I'm not going to narrate at all. I'm just going to try out some of these weapons inside the Overseer's office. And there you have a small, short showcase of the weapons and armor that will be available during the... I love this pistol. That will be available during the Steel Dawn questline. Thanks so very much for watching, and I'll see you out in the wasteland.